We want to find the overall heat transfer coefficient for a thin-walled. And the reason we say it's thin-walled is that we can neglect conduction through the wall, counterflow, concentric heat exchanger. It's going to heat pressurized water using hot gases. The water comes in at a mass flow rate of 1 kilogram per second. Its heat capacity is 4,197 joules per kilogram K. It comes in at 40 degrees C and exits at 140 degrees C, the gas. Mass flow rate is 1.9 kilograms per second. Its heat capacity is equal to 1,000 joules per kilogram Kelvin. It comes in at a temperature of 350 degrees C and exits at a temperature of 100 degrees C. What we're looking for is that U, or overall heat transfer coefficient. As I mentioned before, our NTU is defined as U times A divided by C min. Therefore, we can find our U by taking the NTU, multiplying it by our C min, and dividing it all by the area. And in this particular problem, our area is 20 meters squared. The next thing we have to do is figure out what the NTU is. And if we look it up on a table, we find for a concentric counterflow heat exchanger that the NTU is 1 divided by this ratio, C sub R, minus 1 multiplied by the natural log of the effectiveness minus 1 divided by the effectiveness times C sub R minus 1. The next thing we have to do is define this effectiveness, which is our heat transfer rate over the maximum heat transfer rate, which is equal to, and we'll look at the hot fluid, the heat capacity rate of the gases times the temperature coming in minus the temperature coming out, all divided by C min TH in minus TC in. Our plan is as follows. First, we need to find all of these heat capacity rates, determine which one is minimum, and find the ratio. Next, we're going to solve for effectiveness. This will then allow us to solve for our NTU. And finally, we can solve for our overall heat transfer coefficient. Let's go ahead and do this. First, we have these heat capacity rates. The cold heat capacity rate is its mass flow rate times its heat capacity. So C sub C is 4,197 watts per K. Our hot heat capacity rate is the mass flow rate of the gas times the heat capacity of the gas, and that's going to equal 1,900 watts per K. So this is going to be our C min. So finally, we find our ratio of C min over C max. So our C sub R is 0.45. Next, we have to find the effectiveness. And note I could have used for our Q dot, either one of the fluids, the hot or the cold, but I chose the hot fluid so that we could cancel these two out. And so we're left with an effectiveness of 0.8. Now we have to use the relationship between the NTU and the effectiveness for our particular flow arrangement. And when we do the calculations, we find that our NTU is 2.1. And finally, we can use this number to solve for our overall heat transfer coefficient. And when we calculate this, we find that our overall heat transfer coefficient is 201 watts per meter squared K.